Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
Hey, this is Reid. Welcome to what will be my last Cube video for this period of Cube being on Magic Online. I hope to make it count. Okay, so I'm looking at a pack where the strongest cards are Pristine Talisman, Elves of Deep Shadow. It's never that bad to start a draft with a one-drop green accelerant. Ravages of War, Entreat the Angels, and Elspeth Terrell. Elspeth Terrell is like, medium power level as far as Planeswalkers go, but Planeswalkers are amazing. Entreat the Angel is a really good finisher. I actually don't know what I should pick here. believe it or not, I think I'm going to take Pristine Talisman. It's not the highest of these cards in terms of power level, but it fits best into the types of decks that I like to draft. Ravages of War is the most powerful card and the most unique, but I've had kind of bad experiences building around that card. So given another nice option, I'm just going to take Pristine Talisman. That's, a little bit extreme, but I really, really like blue control. And Pristine Talisman can fit in any color. Could be like a black control deck or a green ramp deck, anything like that. Okay, so by far the most powerful card is Channel. And it's actually the only really good card here. Vampiric Tutor and Entomb are good in like combo decks, but not really that good ordinarily. And then these two lands are very good mana fixers, and Rishon Port is good in a monocolor aggro deck. But nothing on the power level Channel, so I'll take that. And, if I get a nice mana sink, then I'll go for a green ramp deck. Nentuko Vigilante is fine filler card in a green deck. I like having incidental artifact and enchantment removal when it's attached to a creature, something like that. Legacy's Allure is fine, not very exciting. Here's a Planeswalker, which you can never really go wrong picking a Planeswalker. Or I could take Watery Grave, which I think is what I'm going to do. It doesn't go well with Channel. It does go well with Pristine Talisman. And as I've mentioned in previous videos, being able to pick up these dual lands has a lot of hidden value because of the way they work with fetch lands. So yeah, this is a tough pick. I could see Vigilante, Legacy's Allure, a Johnny, or a Watery Grave all being fine picks. Personally, I'm going to go with Watery Grave. This is pretty clear Tidings. It's the best card in this pack by a mile, one of the best cards in the cube. Felonite Hermit's fine in green, but the only green card I have is one whose power level depends on getting, like a small handful of other available cards. So I definitely don't want to consider myself as locked into green. And blue's the best color in the cube. I have a blue mana fixer, and I have an artifact that's really good in blue control decks. Plus, I could just go blue-green if I wanted to. I'm going to take Day of Judgment here. Slightly inconvenient that I have the blue-black dual land instead of the blue-white dual land, but I've noticed actually that they toned down the number of no questions asked board sweepers in the cube. Or, it seems that way from my experience. So having one of the most efficient ones in your blue control deck is very valuable. Elixir of Immortality is like a card that you think of as being really good in a blue control deck, and indeed I have played it in the right circumstances, but you usually can get some Titans or Planeswalkers to win the game just fine if you're drawing enough cards to make Elixir good anyway. Into the Royal, Forbid, Sphere of the Sun, Seaside Citadel, and Decree of Justice. Artifact mana is priceless, especially because the decks, you know, that are going to feature these cards tend to not have that many relevant early plays. That said, Sphere of the Suns is the weakest of the artifact accelerants by a pretty large margin, especially in a control deck, because obviously it runs out of charges, so if the games go long, you're not going to get full use out of it. But I think it's none of the cards are quite special enough to take over Sphere of the Suns, the best one probably being Forbid. But I'll pick up the Mana Accelerate when I can. And along the same lines, I'm going to take Mind Stone here. Miscalculation and Deep Analysis are both good, as are Explore, Harmonize, and Natural Order. But Mind Stone is going to make my deck no matter what, and I won't have many other chances at artifact mana. Okay, I guess I'll take Godless Shrine. Even though I don't have a black card, if I do go blue-white control and have both of these black dual lands, I'll have the option to splash something. Palancron is like mediocre win condition. I would probably only take it if it was late in the draft and I was desperate. Or, you know, if I was trying to build some kind of combo deck with Mirari's Wake or Heartbeat of Spring. But that's not the way this is going, so Godless Shrine. Wow, Ravages of War Wield. That was a card that I was considering first picking, if you remember. Not traditionally great in these control decks, but I do have three sources of artifact mana, so I could, you know, find a way to use Ravages of War, or I could have as a good sideboard card, and at least picking it here means it's one less thing to worry about when we get to the gameplay. Courthouse R is great in blue-white. Glacial Fortress, more important than picking up a filler card like Legacy's Allure, even though Legacy's Allure is a fine card that I'm not disappointed to play with. I could see any of these three being the pick. I'm not going to take Thieving Magpie. I'm going to take Sunken Ruins to make possible Black Splash very comfortable. Catastrophe is good for... It's just a more expensive sweeper, you know? Definitely not as good as Day of Judgment, but still usually playable. I hate these lands, but I have no need to take either of the other cards. I'm pretty happy with how this first pack went. Looks like I probably won't be playing with Channel, but I'm on track for just a really nice blue-white control deck. Simple, consistent, I have good mana already. Possibility of splashing if the right cards come along. So, Undermine is fine. Creeping Tar Pit's great. Path to Exile is good. Ultimate Price is good. But I'm going to take Aetherling. It's the most reliable win condition available for a deck like this. And maybe I can wheel like a Mana Fixer or a removal spell. Wow. Okay, the most powerful cards are Sword of War and Peace and Raphelos. Doesn't look like I can really make use of those cards, particularly not Raphelos. So I'm going to look at Seagate Oracle or Emyria Angel. Probably Seagate Oracle, just to smooth out the draws a little bit. Emyria Angel is like a really good card, but it's kind of in that hazy middle ground where it's not perfect for a deck like this. Given that I'm going to be playing sweepers, I don't really want to add a creature to the board unless it's really going to dominate the game on its own. Myriad Angel is close to good enough to dominate on its own, but not quite. And sometimes if they play like, you know, two guys or a powerful creature, you're going to end up having to wrath it away itself, which is why I tend to lean on stuff like Aetherling, Planeswalkers, and even like the super powerful Titan's Wyrmcoil Engine type cards as my win conditions for this type of deck. Note also, it would have been reasonable to take Sword of War and Peace and then try to go for like a Cawblade type of deck where I play some in the middle type of creatures and just build a blue-white deck full of good cards. But given that I have Day of Judgment, Artifact Mana, and Yeah, I mean, basically I have everything so far. I have a great win condition, a great card draw spell, great mana acceleration, and a great sweeper. So everything's in place for me to build that really desirable control deck, and I feel no reason to have to deviate from that strategy. So a Johnny Gold main, one of the worst planeswalkers for this type of strategy, but you can pretty much always put any planeswalker in your deck and have it be fine. I would probably lean towards the side of picking Kiora and trying to splash for it, or at least having the option to splash for it. There's not much else in my colors that I'm too interested in. Dungeon Geist is fine, kind of suffers from the same problem that I just mentioned about Emyria Angel. So yeah, I'm going to take Kiora here, and if the green mana fixing comes, it comes. If not, then I didn't miss out on too much. Wow. So obviously Breeding Pool is great, given that I just picked up Kiora, but Mirari's Wake is insane. Especially getting it relatively early, being able to plan around it a little bit. And if I'm going to be splashing green, I really want Mirari's Wake in my deck. So this is a classic choice of whether to be conservative, have the good mana and the very light splash, or whether to be a little bit more greedy and get the power. And I'm going to choose to be more greedy. Note that Garrick Primal Hunter is also great, but this is, I'm not on track to have a triple green type of deck. Unfortunate that I keep getting blue-black mana fixing when I don't have any black cards yet. Teferi is pretty good. I'll usually play it, or I mean, I'll always play it in my deck, but it's not, like, stellar. Memory Jar is good with Mirari's Wake, but bad otherwise. And I could take Underground Sea, continuing to speculate on a potential black splash. I'll take Teferi. Especially with picking up so much mana and being a little bit dicey on what colors I'm playing, I might end up stretching for playables a little bit. So here I have a choice between Tropical Island, Flooded Strand, and Force of Will. Force of Will is great. I really don't want to pass it. And I'm not going to. Despite how valuable Tropical Island would be to me right now, I'm not willing to pass Force of Will. It's really, really good in decks like this. It's perfect with Tidings. It's really good against me if someone else has it. Yeah, I don't think I can pass Force of Will. Daze and Riftwing Cloudskate are both pretty good. I'm going to go with Riftwing Cloudskate here. Remember, of course, that I don't have to play green. I would like to. And perfect, I'm able to pick up Flooded Grove here to make that a little bit more of a reality. So now I have Flooded Grove and Sphere of the Suns, which is, you know, pretty well on track. And now I have Temple Garden, great. So I'll be playing Bant here. Probably not going deep enough into green to play Fintorn Elves. I could pick Skeletal Scrying. I could pick Misdirection as a sideboard card. I guess I'll just take Fintorn Elves. I guess I could still go like green-blue, splashing Mirari's Wake if I wanted to. Also just cutting green, counterdrafting the best card in the pack. Kiora, Pentad Prism, Devil's Play. Maybe this Kira's fine. I'll hope I don't have to play with this card, but maybe. Well, this is a little bit of a weird draft. I'm not completely sure what my finished product's going to look like.